right? Mm-mm. 8 days ago, the guinea pig had pain and crying the whole day long, as if for the looking for attention according to the owner. But I did the X-ray and found a bladder stone. That was eight days ago. And the other view, the ventral dorsal view as well, the bladder stone is quite big. And the ventral dorsal view also show a bladder stone. How about the kidneys? Kidney looks okay, right? Then he's a lot of stools, so advise the owner to give Fibroplex and feeding so that the stools come out. Stools came out right now. So the guinea pig was hand fed and was okay for the last 8 days, but of course he wasn't eating on his own. It's a young guinea pig. Then today I palpated a swollen bladder and fever, and this X-ray can show that this bladder is very swollen, like a small golf ball, not like a golf ball. And the guinea pig is recumbent, not able to stand today. And let's see the other view. The other view would show this time the stone is, it appears to be lodged in the urethra, but so obstructing the flow of urine. Let's see the other view again, back to the lateral view. And the lateral view, you can see that lateral view, you can see this is earlier view, no, this is today's view. Yeah, you can see that there's a urethra obstruction. Owner says the guinea pig did pass urine with blood. And so it confirms my diagnosis of urethra obstruction. And that's the reason why the guinea pig cannot walk. And this is the guinea pig here. It lost about 50 grams over 8 days. And it's much, it's still not dehydrated or anything, because the owner hand feed and give water, 500 ml as suggested. So now what to do? Because the fever is there, so give anti-fever fluid, and the only option is surgery to remove the bladder stone. Is there any more stool stuck there? Wait, let me see. Is there any stool stuck there? No. Anyway, it's too late now. So okay, so that is a case study of the guinea pig with bladder stone. Now today is urethra obstruction. It's a young guinea pig, much loved. Now you can see there's no more abdominal swelling, no more abdominal distension as 8 days ago. Not so much pain in the abdomen. No squealing. And so X-ray confirmed urethra obstruction. And in retrospect, I was speaking to the owner today, maybe I should have operated on the fifth day when the guinea pig has passed out all the stools and was able to walk around and go back to his own cage. But the problem is he wasn't eating on his own, and he does squeal when he passes motion or urine. He was given painkillers 4 days, antibiotics 4 days, oral, Fibroplex. Now critical care, the owner couldn't find it in the pet shop, but actually I had it. And so the owner ground the pellets and feed him 6 times a day and 500 ml of water by syringe. And he did a good job, because as you can see, the guinea pig did pass out all the stools, and there was no more impacted colon. So every time he passes stool, he cries, and his urine was passed in large amounts 3 days ago, but recently there was less or can't be seen. And owner definitely saw spots of blood inside the urine. So I thought guinea pig could eat on its own, but as you can see, now he looks a bit better. I've given the painkillers, but there's a high anesthetic risk of opening up and removing the stone from the bladder, but now there's urethral obstruction, and the obstruction is at the urethra of the bladder. So there's a problem now because surgery is not advisable. He's got fever now, and this is where it is very risky to do surgery, and yet if we don't do, the guinea pig will not be able to pee. At this time, the X-ray shows bladder is swelling to about golf ball size. It was palpable, and but at least now he can walk. This morning, the owner told me that he couldn't walk at all, and his eyes were glassy. I thought he had passed away, but now with the painkiller, it looks like he looks quite alert. Now the bladder wasn't overly distended yet, and so now, since I actually confirmed urethral obstruction, so what to do now? There's a question. There's a big decision to be made, and to operate, guinea pig may die. Not to operate, he will die because of back pressure, backflow of urine affecting the kidneys, and of course leading to death, to toxemia, so fever as well. So I have to let the owner decide whether to operate or not to operate today, as it is such a difficult decision to make. But at least there's evidence from the X-ray, which you saw just now, that the swollen bladder was due to an obstruction by the big stone at the urethral end of the bladder. It couldn't come out. But as you can see now, 1 hour after my painkiller injection, this guinea pig at least can walk, but it's not really lively. And this is a dilemma, to operate or not to operate, because chances of survival are low due to anesthetic risk. And the fact that the guinea pig wasn't fully recovered and eating on its own. It's much loved by the owner, the young couple. So this is the situation as at now. Wednesday, July 13, 8 days after the initial X-ray diagnosis of bladder stone, and the supportive therapy given by the owner was excellent because it was 8 days ago. He wasn't eating for 1 week and had been crying for 1 week before that. So the decision is up to the owner whether to operate or not. Toa Payoh Vets, Singapore. Large bladder stone in a young male guinea pig about 2 years old.